Well, if you're new to identifying trees, or if you've been at it a while and are still having a little bit of confusion with it, wanted to talk about distinguishing your types of oak trees, your two basic types here in the Midwest. Now, there are others beyond this, believe me, but right here in central Indiana, the two primary species that we all are sort of interested in are your white oaks and red oaks. And we've got a good classic example here of a side hill ridge that's got both white and red oaks growing on it. And wanted to point out a few differences right here so you can visually kind of see what we're talking about. This is Quercus alba, white oak, and it's identifiable by its really creamy, light-colored bark, almost a beige look to it. And as you run your hand across it, it has somewhat of just a soft bark, and it peels off pretty easily. You can see everything's fairly vertical too in the pattern on the bark. But the dead giveaway is that real pretty beige trunk. You know, not a lot of scaling, but don't be fooled, because some white oaks can have more of a peel, almost slightly resembling a shagbark hickory look. And I've talked to timber guys and buyers, and for whatever reason, those trees that have the white oaks that have a little bit more of a scale seem to have a better grade of wood, for whatever reason that might be. But the other distinguishable characteristic on the white oak is its leaf. And if you can just remember that the white oak has rounded lobes, deep cuts and rounded lobes. And the main distinguishable characteristic between a red oak and a white oak is that lobe on the leaf. A red oak is going to have pointed tips, very sharply pointed tips. And you'll also notice that the lobe's cuts typically aren't as deep. They can be, but on a traditional across-the-board pattern of averages, you're going to see that it has very sharp tips and more of a main solid frame leaf that doesn't have quite the deep lobing that a white oak does. Talking about red oaks now, switching over to the bark, there's one about 10 feet up the bank here. The good old Quercus ruba red oak, northern red oak here, Indiana, has a very dark gray gunmetal appearance. And the bark is really super hard. It's hard to get anything to exfoliate off of that. It's tight to the trunk. And if you'll notice, the veining or the lining in between the bark pattern is there's quite a bit of almost cross hatching in there. It's not perfectly vertical. Again, there's always variations, but that's a good rule of thumb to go by, that dark gray, super hard bark, and those sharp pointed tips on the leaves, and you're gonna be sure that that's a red oak. Hey guys, thanks for watching. Make sure you comment and subscribe. Make sure you subscribe. Hey guys, thanks for watching. Comment below and be sure to subscribe, because we've got a lot more great content coming for you on the Land Beat series.
Whoa! Woot, woot, woot!